What are your names, please?
My name is Pat Finn. I'm the 1961 Orange Bowl Queen.
My name is Midshipman Joe Matulevich. I'm the captain of the Navy football team.
My name is Joe Matulevich, and this is Miss Pat Finn.
I'm Pat Finn, and this is Midshipman Joe Matulevich.
Only one of these couples is really Pat Finn and Joe Matulevich. The other two couples are imposters and will try to fool this panel. Johnny Carson, Kitty Carlisle, Don Amici, and Betty White on To Tell the Truth with your host, Bud Collier.
Thank you very much. Good evening and welcome once again to Tell the Truth. Brought to you this week by Helene Curtis, makers of fine beauty products, creators of Tender Touch Dry Skin Bath Oil, and Helene Curtis Spray Net, regular and super soft. All right, panel, will you kindly, for the first time tonight, open your envelopes and take out your affidavit cards and follow along as I read. I, Pat Finn, a student at Florida State University and the 1961 Orange Bowl Queen, I was selected from 250 candidates to reign over the festival, which is held in Miami, Florida, from December 22nd to January 7th. I, Joe Matulevich, am captain and fullback of the United States Naval Academy football team. We climax our successful season on January 2nd by playing the University of Missouri in the Orange Bowl in Miami. Signed, Pat Finn, Joe Matulevich. Agree, panel, that we have here three extremely attractive ladies and three very handsome escorts, all claiming to be Pat Finn and Joe Matulevich. And we'll start this first round of questioning tonight with Johnny Carson. Johnny?
Do we just say couples instead
of... No, you ask...
The man or the
man
woman?
Man number one, lady number one.
The lady in number one. I did a show called Queen of the Orange Bowl once. Did you happen to see it?
No, I didn't.
Oh. Well, you're not alone, I guess. number three, the gentleman. What time is 2200?
2200?
Yes.
That would be 10 o'clock.
Gentleman number two, what time is 1100?
Now, that'd be 9 o'clock in the evening, sir.
Gentleman number one, what are 8 bells?
8 bells, 12 o'clock.
Well, girl number three, what are 8 bells?
I have no idea.
That's,
8 bells
that's
or 8 girls that look like her.
Ah, well put, Kitty. Gentleman number three, what is 4.0?
4.0? That is equivalent to 100% at the Naval Academy of Marketing.
Gentleman number...
Kitty?
Number one, who gave the graduating address this year in Annapolis?
President of the United States.
Number two, can you tell me who's the commandant of the Naval Academy?
That'd be Admiral Davidson.
Number three, can you tell me who gave the graduating address this year?
Well, we didn't graduate yet this year, so I don't remember.
Number one, can you tell me where the airport is in Miami, Florida?
I have never been to...
I mean lady number one.
No.
Lady number two, can you tell me where it is?
No, I can't.
Number three, bell number three.
Don Amici.
Number one, Miss Finn, are you from Miami?
No, I'm not.
Number two, are you, young lady, Miss Finn?
Yes, I am.
You're from Miami. Number two, where does Bell Harbor start?
Oh, I'm sorry, I don't know.
You don't know? Number three, would you know?
It's a little north of Miami, I believe.
Number two, gentlemen, what is another name for backfield in motion?
Illegal procedure.
Number three, what is the penalty for roughing the kicker?
Roughing the kicker would be 15 yards.
Number one, what is the difference between offensive and defensive offside?
Defensive offside? It's the offensive man and defensive man.
Do you know the difference, number two?
The yardage.
Betty?
Thank you, Bud. Miss Pat, number two, what are the colors of Florida State University?
Black and white.
Number three, do you agree with that?
Garnet and gold.
Garnet and gold. Number one, what are the colors?
Blue and gold.
Oh, very dressed. Mr. Matulevich, number one, who is the captain of the University of Missouri football team?
Danny LaRose.
Number two, gentlemen, how many bells is 1 o'clock in the morning?
1 o'clock in the morning, that'd be 12:30.
Number three, how many? I think I'm being took. Number three, how many bells at 1 o'clock in the morning?
How many bells?
How many bells?
I mean, two bells.
Number one, how many bells?
That's two bells.
Two bells.
That's it. There's a lot of bells, and it's meaning that it's time to vote. So if you will, please, panel, get set to mark your ballots without consultation. We'll vote, please, for number one, couple number one, couple number two, or couple number three. And the team of challengers will, of course, receive $250 for every incorrect vote. Everyone ready? All ballots marked. All right, Johnny, for whom did you vote? Which couple?
Number three.
Couple number three?
Yeah, I was in the Navy. Unfortunately, it was a Japanese Navy, but there's nothing to do with it.
You were a spy, obviously.
Yes, I was a spy. I would say just on the Navy terms alone.
Okay, Kitty?
Well, I voted for number three. Number one said that President Eisenhower gave the address. I think it was Cabot Lodge. And number two got mixed up. He was awfully hesitant about the bells. And number three gave me a funny answer about something. I can't remember what it was, but I still think it's number three.
Don, what is your selection?
I voted for number three. The young lady said Bal Harbour was north, and he knew what the penalty was for roughing the kicker, and the other two didn't seem to know quite what penalties were in football.
Betty, your vote.
Well, I voted for number three. Number two's haircut didn't look quite Navy to me. Number one certainly has the right haircut, but number three's leaning over Pat's shoulder like he's in the Navy.
Well, all right, there we have placed our votes, and we've cast our own peculiar die, and we find out what color comes up from it as we discover which one of these lovely couples is number one, the Orange Bowl Queen, and her escort, the captain of the Navy football team. So Willa Reel, Pat Finn, and Joe Matalavage, please stand up. Well, thank you very much. And you really did well. You start off with a bang. That's great. Let's find out about the others now. Number one, couple number one, you tell us who you both are, please.
My name is Suzanne Hoffman, and I'm an assistant art director with the Norcross Greeting Card Company.
I'm Bob Siegel. I'm a design engineer with Foster Wheeler.
And couple number two, would you introduce yourselves and tell us what you do?
My name's Mike Roscoe, and I'm a field superintendent for the Peter Mitchell Construction Company in Greenwich, Connecticut.
My name is Linda Beeman, and I'm from Salt Lake City, Utah.
Panel, just one little bit of side information. If Linda Beeman looks familiar to you, the young lady who just spoke to you last, don't be at all surprised. She is former Miss USA and the current Miss Universe. Well, let's check our score now. We find out there were 1, 2, 3, 4 correct votes, which means $250, $150 contributed by our sponsor, Helene Curtis. And that's so it shouldn't be a total loss all the way down the line. A very Merry Christmas to you nice people. It's been a joy having you with us. And on your way out, there's a gift package of fine beauty products from Helene Curtis. I hope you enjoyed your visit.
Thank you.
It's nice having you. Good night.
You.
Merry Christmas. Now, panel, let's meet our next team of challengers.
What is your name, please?
My name is Bill Bear.
My name is Bill Bear.
My name is Bill Bear.
Again, follow along with your affidavit cards, if you will, please, panel. I, Bill Bear, am a special investigator for the Chicago and Northwestern Railroad. Recently, at Missouri Valley, Iowa, against 25 top competitors, I won for the second time the Goose Calling Championship of the World. Signed, Bill Bear. Gentlemen, I'm sure, just claiming to be Bill Bear, goose caller and railroad detective, and we'll start this round of questioning with Kitty Carlisle. Kitty?
Thank you, Bud. I know there's a joke around here somewhere, but I can't seem to figure out what it is. What is the connection between a special agent for the Chicago and Northwestern Railroad, number one, and goose calling?
There is no connection between the two.
No connection at all. Well, how do you get to be a goose caller, number two?
With a lot of practice.
No doubt. Number three.
And a friendly goose or
two. Are geese monogamous?
I beg your pardon?
Are geese monogamous?
Not that I know of.
Number one, how many whooping cranes are there in the country?
I believe at the last count, it was 18, I believe.
Number two, can you give us... Oh.
Who would care except another crane?
Donovan, number two, what is the Chicago Northwestern Station in Chicago?
It is the Chicago Northwestern Station.
Number three, where is it in Chicago?
It's on LaSalle Street, I believe.
Number one, would you agree with that?
It's on Canal Street.
Number two, what is the Northwestern's first stop in Iowa going west on its main route?
Clinton.
Number three, does... Betty?
Thank you, Glenn. Number one, what is a third rail?
A third rail, we don't have them on our railroad, but it's a rail to carry electricity.
You shouldn't step on it, in other words. Number two, do you have anything to do with the hobos who ride the rails?
Oh, yes.
What, may I ask?
It's our job to remove them from the property.
Number three...
That's putting it rather nicely, I think.
Is there any legal ruling against people riding the rails, as it were?
Well, yes.
What is the... Under what jurisdiction does
that
ruling?
Well, they're on private property for trespassing.
Number one, are geese monogamous?
Yes.
That's nice to know, I think.
I think it's, you know, I think everybody could take a lesson from
that. That's right. There's a future in these United States. Johnny.
Number two, call me a goose. I know what you're going to say. You're a goose. No, but can you do a goose call? Is that a fair question?
That's not part of it. No.
Well, you can't ask him to do a goose call.
No.
You know where, number three, do you know where Corning, Iowa is?
No, I don't believe I do.
Number the railroad th-
number
doesn't
two,
go in there.
Do you know where Logan, Iowa is?
Well, it's in the
how far from Missouri Valley? How far
from Missouri Valley? Well, approximately 10 miles.
Number one, how far from Missouri Valley is Logan, Iowa?
I would put a little further, 20.
20. Number three, who?
Number three, that's it. Once again, the bells are calling, and they may call the geese before we get through. Let's find out as we discover which one of these gentlemen is the real one. You have to vote first, so will you please mark your ballots without consultation and vote for number one, number two, or number three. Okay, all set. Johnny, what is your vote?
I'm still working on Corning from
are
last
you?
Week. Nobody's... Well, my grandfather lives in Logan, Iowa. He used to be the mayor of Logan, Iowa. No joke. And which is about 18 or 20 miles from Missouri Valley, so I say number one.
Kitty.
Well, I'm in a terrible quandary because number one looks like a goose caller, but number two, whom I voted for, looks like a railroad agent. And number three...
Railroad engine looks like
a... agent. And number three doesn't look like either one.
I don't know how one looks like a goose caller, but in any event, Don Amici, which one do you think is the real one?
I voted for number one. I had to rule three out because the Northwestern Station is not on LaSalle Street, and it is on Canal and Madison, I believe, if I'm not mistaken. So,
Betty.
Well, I voted for number three because I don't want anybody to feel left out. He feels rejected if somebody doesn't vote for him.
Well, psychologically speaking, there we are. Once again, at our moment of truth, let's find out for our own satisfaction before we literally burst and discover which one of these gentlemen is the real goose caller and railroad detective. So will the real Bill Bear please stand up?
Three, two.
Ah! Before you sit down, sir, I'm going to satisfy Johnny's curiosity of a moment ago. Would you give us a sample of a champion goose call?
Thank
you, sir. You notice he even flapped his wings a little bit there as he called. Number one, would you tell us your real name and what you really do?
My name is Tom Fry. I'm New York manager for Workforce Incorporated, specialist in temporary employment.
And you look like a goose cook. And number three, your real name and what you do, please.
Well, my name's Darby Nelson, New York City, and I'm a motion picture and television director.
Checking our score, we find this time there are 1, 2, 3 incorrect votes. You did better against the panel this time. And so that means the $250 each, there's a total there of $750 from Helene Curtis. And, of course, a gift package of fine beauty products from Helene Curtis for your ladies. Thank you for being with us.
Thank you. Good night.
God bless you.
Thank you.
Now let's meet our third team of challengers, panel.
What is your name, please?
My name is Dr. William B. Walsh.
My name is Dr. William B. Walsh.
My name is Dr. William B. Walsh.
For the details of the current case, there's another affidavit to read. Will you follow along with your copies, please? I, Dr. William B. Walsh, am head of the President's People-to-People Health Foundation. In 1958, I got the idea of equipping an American hospital ship to teach modern medical methods in the newer and less advanced countries of the world. President Eisenhower provided a Navy hospital ship, and with the help of American industry, American labor, and money donated by thousands of private citizens, Project Hope was launched. In September, staffed with 60 American physicians, nurses, and technicians, the SS Hope sailed from San Francisco, bound for Indonesia. I have recently returned from the ship. The reaction of the Indonesian people and their government has been beyond our expectations. Our eventual aim is a fleet of ships like the SS Hope deployed throughout the world. Signed, William B. Walsh. Three gentlemen panel, this time, of course, with a different story, all claiming to be Dr. William Walsh, organizer of Project Hope. And we'll begin this round with Betty White. Betty?
Thank you, Bud. Well, first of all, just let me say congratulations on such a wonderful idea. And one point of information, which may not help us guess the right answer, but you spoke of the reception from the Indonesian people. Number one, how many actual medical students, you might call them, did you contact in Indonesia?
You mean just the students or all the medical
people? The medical people who came to take advantage of your facilities.
Yes. So far, there have been about 350.
Number two, how many would you say came to the ship and responded to your idea?
About 350.
Number three?
About 350.
Oh, thanks a lot. Number two, what is the captain's name on the SS Hope?
Captain Jack Mendes.
Number three?
Johnny Carson.
Dr. Walsh, number three, Dr. Walsh. Is it starve a cold and feed a fever, or feed a cold and starve a fever? I've never been able to get it straight.
I don't understand the question.
All right, doctor. you, I'm not coming to. Doctor number two, is it starve a cold and feed a fever, or feed a cold and starve a fever?
Well, I'm afraid you'd have to give me a little more information about the patient's symptoms.
You sound like my doctor. Doctor number one, what's the capital of Indonesia?
Jakarta.
I thought he was going to say feet of cold.
Doctor number one, what would you recommend for a constricted metacarpal?
A dictionary.
Kitty, please.
Well, I'm proud to be on a program with Dr. Walsh, whoever he is, because I think this is such a marvelously, truly American idea to bring... all of our know-how to the less well... people who have less goods than we do in the world. Number one, who's the president of the American Medical Association?
Dr. Vincent Askey.
Number two, what is the color of the SS Hope?
White.
White. Number two, number three, what is the capital of Thailand?
Bangkok.
Don Amici, please.
Number three, what is the most used anesthesia for operations?
In Indonesia?
No.
Ether. Ether. Or...
would you agree with that, number two?
Well, Nematol.
Number one, what would you inject in the veins for a kidney stone examination?
For the examination?
Yes.
One of the iodine dyes.
Number two, what gland controls blood sugar balance?
The thyroid.
Number three, would you agree with that?
Pancreas.
Pardon me?
The pancreas.
Number one, how would you determine the difference between a diabetic coma and insulin shock?
Don, what? You must be awfully sick.
Well, you can run the pH, the acidosis alkalosis balance on it.
Number.
That's it. Boy, I'm telling you, this is all over my head tonight. Wow. Any event, we're trying to come to the conclusion of everything. Let's find out which one is right or wrong after we mark our ballots. If you will do so now, panel, and vote without consultation for number one, number two, or number three. All ballots marked. All right, Johnny, what is your selection this trip?
Well, whoever the real doctor is, I have great admiration for him, but I'm going to vote for number one because he got a good laugh, and anybody who gets a laugh on television nowadays, I'll vote for.
Kitty, which one do you think is the real one?
I voted for number three. Number two is not a doctor. He said that Nembutal was a, what did you say, you know, Don.
Anesthesia.
Anesthesia, yeah. That's not true. And number one, I think, is a medical student because he knows a great deal about it, but he's too young to be the real one, so I voted for number three.
Don, your selection.
I voted for number three, although I must say it strictly was a toss-up between one and three, so far as I was concerned.
And Betty, for whom did you cast your ballot?
Well, I voted for number three. Number one looked so serious, and he stared right at us into acidosis, piccolosis, whatever. But number three gave such evasive answers that I have a strong feeling he is it. Excuse me.
All right, there we have it now. And let's find out in our, again, conclusive moment of bringing all things to a head. Let's see which one of these three gentlemen is the real organizer of Project Hope. And with that in mind, may we ask the real Dr. William Walsh to please stand up. Doctor, I want you to remain... I want to tell the doctor something. I wasn't asking to stand up for more applause because he certainly deserves it. It's a marvelous thing, and Kitty, thank you for expressing it so well for all of us. But I have some news for you, doctor, that you don't know about. We got it from the wire services. A little surprise for you, Dr. Walsh. We just received a bulletin in our wire service that the first baby, an Indonesian baby girl, has just been born on board the SS Hope. Thought you'd like to know. Now, number one, did you tell us your real name and what you really do with your acidosis, whatever it was?
My name is Har Davis. I'm a radio television producer for the Kudner Advertising Agency.
Well, you ad-lib real well. It was a good job. Number two, your real name and what you do, please.
My name is Ira Scott. I'm a professor of finance at Columbia University.
Thank you. I think we all feel healthier tonight after that little set, too. Checking the score, we find there are 1, 2, 3 correct and only one incorrect. That means, of course, a total of $250 from Helene Curtis. But I'd like you to know that we are going to donate the difference between that and $1,000 or $750 to Project Hope. Also, there's a gift package of fine beauty products for your ladies. Good night, gentlemen, and God bless you. Well, that's all the time we have for tonight, except a little bit of information for all of our viewers in the Boston area. As of January 2nd, 1961, To Tell the Truth will be seen on WHDH-TV, Channel 5. Guess that about wraps it up, panel. I hope you hope along with me, however, that sort of one night a year, everything that symbolizes hope and faith and love and truth comes upon the world, and I think it'd be great if we could work a little harder to keep it there the rest of the year. Do you agree?
Indeed I do.
God bless you. That's about it. Good night, panel.
Good night,
Bud. Good night,
Bud. Bud Collier saying good night from Helene Curtis and reminding you to tell the truth. Good night, everybody.
To Tell the Truth is a Mark Goodson, Bill Todman production in association with the CBS Television Network. Johnny Carson may be seen daily on Who Do You Trust? To Tell the Truth has been brought to you tonight by Helene Curtis, makers of End and Dandruff Treatment Shampoo, and Helene Curtis Spray Nut Regular and Super Soft. Johnny Olson saying goodnight from To Tell the Truth, pre-recorded.